70 plays written by 35 Boston area playwrights. Staged by 6 really awesome local directors and a the 1 Minute Play Festival is a New York-based theater company. We travel all around the country and we partner with theaters who either have community-specific or playwright-specific missions to create this festival with a unique identity in each city. And I'm really happy to be here partnering with Kate and BPT.
That would be us. Yeah. Thank you so much for coming, Dominic. This has been a gas, I have to say. And you know, the energy of this reminds me of anybody who's been in this space for the Boston Theater Marathon 14 years ago remembers the energy that it was like. You know, it's electric back there. They can't wait to be out here. I can't wait to see it. I wanted to tell you that you know, all of these artists are working for free, and we all hate that. So I want you to know, seriously, they deserve so much more. And I want you to know that every penny that we make off of this festival will go back to helping the playwrights in this community with staged readings, and also we're helping the companies in this venue who are doing new work. And so it will go back to you, I promise. Thank you so much for coming. And that's it.
Yeah, thanks for supporting us.
Nobody's name is Hay. That's what my son tells me now. One of his preschool teacher's mantras. What's wrong with saying hey to get someone's attention? I mean, weren't we taught a rose by any other name? Soon I won't be able to say, hey, shut up! Or hey, cut the crap! Or hey, you want to slap? You're soon will be telling me that smoking is bad, or that drinking too much will cause liver damage, or that those pay-per-view channels are nothing more than the blatant exploitation of women. I mean, I'm starting to lose control of them. And I don't like it.
So how's school?
It's okay.
Great. And mom?
Okay.
Great. Who are you,
No.
Are we done here? You want anything else? Coke? Candy?
Actually, can I get an orange juice?
Can you get one orange juice, please? No ice. You don't like ice, right?
No, except for...
Yeah.
Except sometimes,
okay.
When I get iced coffee, and my mouth gets really
right.
Cold inside of it, it but sends these rays of freeziness right through my teeth, right into my brain.
Okay.
And my
do it
brain
now.
Is cold, I can think.
Pull the trigger. No ice, right?
Yeah, no ice.
Honey. Yeah, I wish that too.
Let me see yours. Oh, you should wear makeup to school.
My mom won't let me.
Neither will mine, but I still do it.
I know.
I should. Blue is my favorite color eyeshadow.
Oh, it's so bright.
I know. Okay, hair next.
Oh, hair next. I want to be a ball gown princess with the bun pulled back to the side and those little wispy things in front covering my face.
Oh, yeah, like Sleeping Beauty at the very end.
Yeah, yeah, here do yours.
My mom said I can't use your brush.
Why?
Because you're black.
So?
Y'all's hair is dirty.
It's not.
My mom said it is. What on earth are you doing?
A presentation. On starvation. Every 2.5 seconds.
I get it. This is ridiculous. Sanjay Malika. You okay?
Yeah, thanks. Every 2.5 seconds, someone dies of starvation.
Awesome! Woo-hoo! Bravo! See? Now, where would you like to go for lunch? Okay, I know this is tough, Liam. I know, but please, don't mention to my father about your situation.
So what did he ask about my situation?
Just make something up, okay? Come on, I want you to meet my parents.
No, I think the fact that we love each other is what's important here, Daphne.
He'll think you're going out with me to get a green card. I told you. It's not worth the headache.
But then what's the point in meeting him if I can't even tell him the truth?
Because I want them to see that I have a boyfriend. That I'm getting on with my life. That they can be proud of me. When you become a citizen here, then we can worry about the truth.
You know what, I think I'll just take a cab back home.
No, no, no. You are going to meet my parents now. And be happy about it. Because you don't want someone to drop a dime and have you deported. Okay, Liam?
What?
I'm joking. It'll be fine. Let's go inside, honey.
I wish I had a boyfriend. If I had a boyfriend, this thing on my head, I've had it since I was 3 years old, and my parents pretend like they don't see it, but I kept them staring at it, so I know they're lying. My grandmother actually admitted to me once that she saw it, and my parents got really angry, so...
I know I was supposed to take out the dog. I'm sorry. I'll do it right now.
Now, it's more than your lack of obedience and bad grades.
Resources are tight. The economy.
I'll start a paper route.
We just can't afford an American kid.
I'll really miss you, honey, but we have photos.
Sanjay won't be quite the same, but his bid was way below what it cost to raise you.
He's already practicing baseball.
See, outsourcing's our only option. Don't take it personally.
Bye-bye, honey. Touchdown! Yeah! Beautiful, isn't it? Planet Earth, home, sweet home.
Don't hog it. It's more on your side.
No, you don't hog it. I don't want it to float away.
Oh, right, like you care.
I care. I care a lot. Here we go. Here we go now. Just because I don't believe it, it's man-made, made-up bullshit, and you know.
The warmest global temperatures in 1,000 years. How?
Natural climatic cycles. Natural.
What? Natural about coal, electricity, gasoline, and all that other crap.
You don't care about our jobs.
You don't care about our grandchildren.
Tree hugger.
Ostrich.
Where'd it go?
You let go.
You did.
Now what?
We get it back.
How?
Pop.
Oh, God.
I just feel so insecure, you know? You feel that way too, don't you?
No.
Whatever, man. How is that? Well, you're not an actor, are you?
No, but I'm out there with you.
No, you are not. You are not. You think you are, but you are not.
What is wrong with you?
Nothing.
Dang, dude, I see the way the audience looks at you.
Us! Looks at us!
Dude, they don't even see me. They are mesmerized by you. They love you, man. They don't even see Dank the actor or Dank, the Siamese twin. They just see Hamlet.
Seriously?
Cross your heart, man. You're my brother.
I don't know if it's an emergency. There's a wolf in my house. No, not a dog. A wolf or a coyote or something wild. I left the door open just a crack, and when I came back, I saw a shape, a shadow, something dark slipping into our house. Just a glimpse. Shaggy, gray, thin, bullied, cold. No, I didn't touch him. Cold. He made me feel cold. He looked at me with a cold stare. Just please come. He's running all around there, breaking everything. My beautiful home, everything we collected together. Stop! It's all my fault. God help me. I let it in.
And so, for reasons no one was quite sure of,
they launched a penguin into space.
Launched it as it soared into the yonder.
And as it left our solar system,
they received just one brief message.
It was an audio message. From an area near Pluto, or thereabouts.
The penguin said,
weather conditions fine,
but send more fish. Everybody listening,
back home,
standing on Earth,
could only think,
and stare,
and wonder,
and ask each other how,
just how,
in this wide world, a penguin,
in a rocket, by itself,
I'd learned to use the radio. I don't understand baseball. Like how there can be a World Series when we don't invite countries like Japan to play. Or why they call it a no-hitter, even if some batters actually do hit the ball. But it goes deeper than that. Like the idea of home. You start out at home. You know, home is where anything is possible, where everything happens. You know, a home run, a strikeout, a bunt, strike! You start out at home. But then, in order to succeed, you have to run away from home. But even as you are running away from home, you are trying your damnedest to get back home, to where you started. Because if you do, crowds cheer. Your ass gets slapped, and everything is peaches and cream.
Strike!
But as you are trying to get home, back to where you started, all these guys are trying to get in your way. And someone is deciding for you on whether you are safe or out. No gray, black and white, safe or out. Running away from home only to return home. A vicious cycle. Oh shit.
Cubs. Oh, come on, man. I can't do this alone.
You're rooting for
Sweet
the laundry.
Caroline.
Strike three. You're... fan. Yes.
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
No. Yes.
Maybe later. Does your husband know you have this much wax in your ears?
Is that your creepy way of asking if I'm married?
God, no! But are you?
Oh my God!
Is that a no?
I have a partner, okay?
So you're an unmarried lawyer?
No! I have...
Say, aww.
Aww.
Well, from the looks of things, you make a man very happy.
Partner, you fucking creep! I'm in a committed relationship, okay? And hear of malpractice as much?
So you are a lawyer. Who's the lucky guy?
She is a woman.
So why couldn't you say girlfriend?
Because there is no language for what we have. Because some straight dude like you decided how we refer to each other.
What is it with women?
You're a good driver. Oh, thanks.
And yet you act guilty. For I am like Judgment Day. Filling your car with a blinding light and your heart with dread. Because we're all guilty of something, aren't we? Aren't we?
Yes.
We're giving friendlies coupons out to good drivers this month. When I bring yours back, you need to do two things.
Sure. What?
Enjoy your fribble. And contemplate your guilt.
You might as well get yourself a decent place. All this researching and writing, intellectual business, and then you come back to this place every night.
But the company's right.
I'm enjoying the company very much.
This about my hotel, or is it a black thing? The South is the South, right?
Do you see me slinking into your room every night?
You right.
I'm already late if I'm not there when the library opens. What time are you coming in?
Need a cup of coffee first. Kind of freaky, though, when you think about it.
I'm telling you, this whole black-white thing is in your head.
That ain't what I'm talking about, dig it. I'm here researching my ancestry at a research library on a plantation your people's own.
I thought we got past all this, which is why we ended up in bed.
That's not it. We both know your people's did a little tiptoeing in the back forwarded.
Excuse me?
Tiptoeing, back forwarded, made some babies. I mean, hell, we could be related.
Wasiznamo?
Yup, that's me.
Wasiznamo, what is that, Polish?
Yeah, it's actually pronounced was his name-o.
And Kevin, was his name-o? Like that?
Yup.
You get that a lot.
I do.
Why don't you just pronounce it differently?
Because it's my family, my heritage.
Well, but it's Americanized, though.
No.
Yeah, can you imagine a Polish person saying, what's his name? No, what? It would be, what's his name, if it's anything.
Okay, well.
Hey, it's a beautiful thing, okay? America, that is your heritage. You don't know any Polish people. You're a goddamn American.
Well,
your grandparents are from here.
Yeah,
embrace it, Kevin, was his name. Embrace your heritage.
Okay, thanks.
America!
America.
When Charlie found me, I was just a pup. He said, I'm gonna teach you a game. He would hide, and it was my job to find him. I'd run and dig till I found Charlie. He'd pet me, give me treats. And I always found him, always. Then Charlie tells me it's time to play for real. He takes me far away to a place where the ground is filled with fire and the air stinks of gasoline. Go on, Mama. Find him. I go digging and digging. I find a hand. I lick and lick, but the hand never moves. Dig some more. Find some other parts, an arm, a leg. These people don't pet me. Don't give me treats. And then Charlie says, Lana, we gotta go. But I won't. He pulls my leash. Lana, we gotta go. And then this loud sound.
Lana, you there, girl?
I find him. I bark and bark, and his fellow soldiers find him. Charlie can't play anymore. But when they send him home, he takes me. And I'm with him. Always.
God and Mary in heaven, please spare the life of my little girl.
Mary can't help her. Nor can God.
Who are you?
I'm one of the good people. You know why she's sick.
She swung on the branch of the fairy tree. Forgive me, the good people's white thorn.
Aye, broke it she did.
Oh, forgive her, good sir. She's but three.
Give her to me. I'll make her well.
I cannot. Her soul belongs to God.
Then let him send down an angel to save her. Just so. He never does. You cannot stop me. Dare you try? I leave her here to our suffering.
Well, if you take her, you'll take me as well, for she'll need me.
But God may want your soul now.
I? But I don't want him. Penny, for your thoughts?
I was thinking, if I could get one perfect day or one perfect hour or one perfect minute out of this trip, that would be something I could hang on to for the rest of the year. And this, right here, right now, might just be it.
Really? What makes it so perfect?
Everything! The sun, the breeze, the smell of the ocean, no scraping the snow off the car, no traffic, no smart-ass kids texting each other about how they think I'm gay.
They don't.
Yeah, they do.
This is lovely.
Yes, sir. Just drinking, thinking, soaking up that sun.
Together.
Right.
Molested as a child?
No.
Are you sure?
Pretty sure.
I bet you were molested.
This is the worst therapy I've ever had.
Well, I am courts appointed.
You don't like me.
It's not about whether
or not. But you don't, though.
I do not, no.
Then what's the point of even having
I don't make the rules.
Don't you want to help people?
I don't care about helping people like you.
Look, I think you went into the wrong line of work then.
Don't tell me what you think about me.
Look, I don't think I was molested, but maybe I suppressed it. Is there something you can do to get it out?
You want me to help you remember getting molested?
Maybe I suppressed it.
Maybe you're just a bad person.
No, maybe you are.
Maybe I am. Time's up.
Thanks for nothing.
Welcome.
Twice a day. You tell me there's no problem with my credit card, but I should call you about an urgent matter.
I've done some voice work in the past.
You call me twice a day?
It's actually a robocall.
I keep wondering, when's Rachel going to call? The tone of your voice, the sense of crisis, then it got to be familiar. More than that,
I really need to get back to my...
If you don't go, I'm gonna call the cops.
Just say a few words. Just say, hi, this is Rachel from Cardholder Services. I love you, Bob. You big, strong man. I love you.
I can't.
Otherwise, I will knock on your door twice a day. Forever.
Hello, this is Rachel from Cardholder Services. I love you, Bob.
I saw the painting.
What painting?
I told you, I went to Ava's gallery this morning. She showed it to me. She has it hidden in the back room.
It isn't hers to show. That's the deal.
You had a deal with Ava?
Not with Ava, with my father. No one could see it unless I said so.
It was overpowering. It was...
private. I was...
naked.
Yes.
Did he force you to do it?
No. He asked me. I said I would. I wanted to do it.
Why?
Because he wanted me to. He was my father. I just did it. There were naked models in the house all the time. It wasn't even a big deal until I...
until what?
Until I saw it.
It was beautiful. The light, the turn of your head, your chest. Now that I've seen it, I feel that I finally know you.
I was 14. It says too much.
Even now?
Especially now.
I found a parking space right out in front of the apartment.
Great. Give me one trip highlight.
Well, a guy at the Stanford rest stop offered me a blowjob.
What?
But then I came right up to the urinal and he said, I could suck you off.
Was anybody else there?
Yeah, there were like three other guys there all doing their business.
So what did you do?
I pulled my pants down, stepped away from the urinal, and I said, have at it. I scared the shit out of the guy because he turned and ran out. And I'm sure I freaked everybody else out too. And I figure, I'll never see these people again, so whatever. Pull my pants up, wash my hands, and get back in the car.
What were you going to do if he didn't walk away?
I don't know.
What do you know?
I wouldn't let him do it. I don't know. I guess I just didn't make it.
I don't remember.
But you stayed here with somebody once.
I've been here before.
Some guy before me.
It was a long time ago.
Was it Lewis?
It was before we ever met.
Hey, you want to get out of the car?
It's snowing.
It isn't sticking.
It's closed for the season, Rob.
No. That neon sign's flashing.
That neon sign is flashing. Closed for the season.
Oh, yeah. Let's get out and stretch our legs, okay?
It's snowing harder.
God, that neon sign sure looks familiar. Pine Summit Lodge. I know I've seen that sign before.
The snow dome.
I know the snow dome.
On the kitchen sill.
Yeah, the snow dome on the kitchen sill. Pine Summit Lodge. So who did you come here with?
I don't remember.
You want to get out?
This is interesting.
What?
Well, we seem to be the only two people left on the face of the earth.
Well, what do you know? I think you're right.
What a catastrophe, that nuclear war, or asteroid hitting the Earth, or wave of bear attacks, whatever.
I think it was an outbreak of a rare flesh-eating virus.
Yes, well, it's all very sad, but it does mean that you and I can start a whole new world.
Does it?
Yeah, together, the two of us, we can generate a new race of people dedicated to peace, love, and harmony, like a new... Adam and Eve.
I see a flaw in your reason.
What flaw?
Well, you and I both are of the same gender. And as such, much less likely to produce offspring than, say, two people at more opposite ends of the gender spectrum. Producing a new race of people might prove to be difficult.
I think we can work something out.
Look, I don't know how to make this any clearer. I'm not going to sleep with you.
Damn!
Hey,
too, I said. I was a sweet girl. We sat down in the empty theater. He handed me popcorn that he wanted. He wouldn't let go of my hands. The way he was rubbing was almost like, no, sweet girls don't think like that. He wouldn't let go of my hand. He decided it was time for his lips to meet mine. It was my first experience, so I didn't know the difference between being thrown down, plunged on cold cement, and being caressed by gently exploring fingers. I thought, this is supposed to feel good, so I kissed back. He drove me home, and I said thank you. I was a sweet girl. I knew I had played my part well, the part I had been trained to play, the only part I knew.
Filming during intermission, so you're going to be on TV.
Well, I'll be in the wrong way.
blocking it.
Looks good. I watched some of it. Yes, I did. Yeah. Hi.
Lovely.
I was not accounting.
You've all been waiting for me, right?
We were waiting for you. You didn't come.
I did come, just now.
We're waiting a long time.
And here I am. Your patience has been rewarded.
We don't need you anymore.
You don't mean that.
Things were really bad before. Really, they were awful. We had to tear everything down and start from scratch. We kept hoping you would come, but you never did.
I did. Come. Look, I'm here.
Too late. We had to make do without you.
You don't mean that.
There is no reason for you to stay.
Of course there is. I can hold you, protect you. I can love you.
Please go.
Don't. Look, don't turn me away, okay? It's lonely out there. It is cold and lonely.
I'm sorry.
Goodbye.
Oh, you'll regret this. Yeah, one day, you'll want to have me around. Ooh, shit.
So, Chapuan's Spoon, instead of turkey?
The last time I was here, it definitely was my salad dressing.
Oh, yeah, I think so.
Oh, I only want it on my toast. If it's albacore, if it's yellowfin, I'm going to have
one pink or get bulky. Two Italians, one with
a cup. Yeah,
but she still doesn't know. I'm next in line. Well, I don't know. 2 minutes.
Could you check?
I just want a chicken salad sandwich. Hi-ya!
Yourself. You're terrific and go fish, as long as someone needs a six.
So, what's the move here?
Oh, you got a hit.
Really?
16? Definitely.
I don't know, the dealer's showing...
No, spare me the dealer. This isn't math, this is mysticism. This is running into your kindergarten teacher at the same out-of-the-way cafe in France. This is dropping your keys at the exact moment that the man you end up marrying can find and return them. This is celestial.
I don't know. I get what you're saying, but,
Stick!
Please, Stick!
Bitch!
Jack of spades.
Oh, see?
Terribly sorry. I think we should have a fight.
Fight?
Yeah. I mean, most relationships start out great, but they reach a point where the guy and the girl, they can't go any further because they don't fight the same way.
You want to have a fight with me right here in public? Why? Are you breaking up with me? Are you bored? Do you want a little drama? Oh, no, wait. This is about your last girlfriend, isn't it? She got the best of you in every argument, and you'd stand there frozen, unable to speak. Unable to get a word in edgewise when she went into one of her tirades that made perfect sense. And you want to see if the same thing is going to happen with me. That's it, isn't it?
Fight's over.
My table's ready. Do you still want to eat?
Not gonna happen.
Yeah. Okay. Okay. Thank you.
Yes. sorry. It's taken.
That's okay. Just thought I'd check.
I was scared.
No.
No?
In person. In person. And that's more for me than for you. Understand? In person, no.
No.
Yes.
Excuse me.
Yes! Damn it, it's taken.
Solar-powered watch that requires no batteries.
That's right. It is. I never lie.
Yeah, but what you failed to tell me is that this is a sundial. What am I supposed to do with this thing?
Wear it?
A sundial? Police! Police!
Look, look! You just face north and look at your watch. It's guaranteed to be 100% accurate.
Okay. Smart ass. How am I supposed to use this thing at night?
You got me? You are a smart customer.
Now what's this? This isn't my money.
The flashlight! On the house.
Okay, fine. Last time you tried to rip somebody off.
Anybody want to buy a new solar-powered watch? Brand new, not yet in stores.
Something's been at the lettuce.
I thought it was cabbage.
Lettuce.
Fine. What are you doing? What is wrong with you?
I do lettuce, carrots, and tomatoes.
Okay.
You sit outside all day, but there's soil under my nails.
I think it would have been here by now. I think this should have been for it, not wrapped as a gift for someone else.
Still, I've never done cabbage.
It's like leaves. Like, who fucking cares? You're out there digging like we're of the freaking land. We live in a triple-decker!
I need my ring back.
You're stuck.
Furnace is all fixed. Be warm as toast in the view. What about that water heater?
What about that water heater?
Want me to look at it?
Why? Is something wrong?
I'm not saying that. Mm-hmm. Not saying that it doesn't. I'm just saying.
Saying what?
It's old.
I know that.
Well, you gotta be careful with old things. Especially water heaters.
Why? What happens?
They can go on you just like that.
Well, why don't I call you when it goes just like that?
You might not be here.
Well, then I won't need hot water.
No, I'm saying you might not be here anymore.
What?
When a thing like that goes.
Wait, you mean it might go? Like explode at any time?
Not a man alive can know when it's time.
Does it shoot out the roof like a rocket? Or does it burst out the sides like a pumpkin?
I don't know.
Oh.
May I join you there?
Oh, no, I'm waiting for someone.
Been walking a long way. May I sit till they get here?
Next to me?
Well, yes. There's an empty space next. Do you understand? Belongs to someone else. I'm only asking to sit.
Well, I guess I can't stop you.
You want to? I only need a minute.
Well, okay, but you won't be sitting with me. You'll just be sitting next to me.
I understand that. Just sitting, not with. Next to. Near.
Are you really just going to sit there rubbing your foot?
I need a little comfort. Who else is going to do
it
for me?
I'm certainly not going to do it.
No, you're not. Oh, is this your...
No, it isn't.
May I sit? She's waiting for someone. Have you been waiting long?
She asked me if I could tell her what city and state we're in. So I did. And then I asked her if she wanted to know what day of the week it was.
Good for you.
She said, Mr. Johnson, how are they treating you? Any complaints? I said, well, it's weird. Whenever I'm almost asleep, someone reaches in under the sheets and massages my calf.
It's those damn vibrating cuffs to keep your circulation going.
Yeah, I know that. I said it as a joke. But she didn't crack. Nope, she kept right on her path. Mr. Johnson, can you tell me what time it is?
She's an idiot. Seriously, we gotta get you out of here as fast as we can. It's so insulting, so demeaning.
It's worse than demeaning, I'll tell you. An awful thing happened to me this morning. I was visited by this young psychiatrist.
It's the wind.
I don't think so.
You can see the leaves.
No, it's something else.
You mean like a ghost or something? What? Now what did I do?
You're not always the victim, you know.
So I'm wrong, is that it? Sure looks like the wind.
Things aren't always what they look like, are they?
Why'd you want to come up here anyway?
It's dark. I get lost in the sound and the wind.
So you do admit that there is actual wind?
I can hide up here.
Who the heck are you hiding from, Serafina? No one knows but us. One stupid thing we did, one stupid action, one regret. People learn to live with hundreds of regrets.
She was ours. We let her go.
A happy family. They wanted her. They needed
her. I needed her!
It's too late, baby. The papers, the law. It's been almost a year now. It's too late. Let's go down, Sari.
I'm hiding. You can't see me.
So, you gonna do the dishes?
Dishes. What
What are dishes?
You know those things you eat off of?
Eat. Oh my God, what's eat?
As in food, that stuff you cook.
I knew a cook once. Alan Cook.
You never mentioned him. Who was he?
Oh, just some kid we knew growing up. He died of leukemia. We were like 14. It was the first time someone we knew who was our age died. It scared us. And I haven't thought about him in a long time.
I'm sorry.
It was a long time ago. You know, I can't even remember what he looked like.
So, you gonna do the dishes?
Turkey was dry, Ma. You ruined Thanksgiving.
Oh, just shut up.
Relax. He was joking. The food was great.
Everything was. Thanks.
You know, if Dad was here, he'd have taken a whole plate of mashed potatoes.
Yeah, and gotten all pissed when you told him he took too much.
And then he never even finished it.
Every year I tell him, Tommy, don't take so much.
We all do.
That was for him.
Just a cut. Keep your old man company.
So not Eddie, right?
Oh, for Christ's sake.
The meeting's this week.
Jesus, Mary and Joseph, did I ask about meetings? I asked if you wanted a goddamn drink.
I said I don't.
Oh, it's a sad day when a daughter
gets. You got coffee, I'll take a cup of that.
Ain't me a lousy meeting. Get the fuck out of town in your car.
I miss Davey, too.
Sure.
Like a hole in the fucking wall.
Sure.
But I can't sit in the cup with you.
Sure. It's a sad day when a father can't hold his son. You're a good girl, Christine. You're a good daughter.
I'm sorry. What did you say?
Nothing. The man in the moon. We used to say this every night, Dad. The man in the moon looked down from the moon.
Moon.
Looked down from the moon and said,
Moon.
'Tis time for all children on the earth to think about
going to the bed.
Give a lesser damn about the casket.
You knew what I meant.
Say what you mean.
Sorry.
Sorry.
Did you hear? The Undertaker apologized. He actually apologized.
Doesn't look anything like him.
Yeah.
I mean, I looked down and I looked for a long time and I thought, doesn't look anything like George.
It doesn't.
I thought.
Yeah?
Maybe if someone put a joint in his mouth?
Hey, Dad. Mom and the boys said I could have a minute alone with you before we leave. On TV, it's different. There's always a private room and final moment to say goodbye. No one tells you that in real life you might not get that chance. And there's only a small curtain separating the worst moment of your life from a man going on about how he can't poop. Which you would have thought was hilarious, by the way. You're going to be okay. Everything's all right now. I hope you weren't scared.
The thing is, it was just too much.
I know. 10 years of taking him to the doctors, washing out his underwear.
Cutting his toenails. It was too much. I have a life. Not much of one, I know, but...
You have a life.
I told him last month when I drove him back from Shaw's, I said I couldn't do what I was doing for him anymore. Of course I'd continue taking him to Shaw's every Wednesday. Of course I'd do that. But the other stuff, it was too much.
What did he say?
He said he understood.
Oh.
Then 2 weeks later, he gets pneumonia and dies.
So, you're kicking yourself for not hanging around a couple of more weeks. 2 more weeks, you'd have been one of the saints instead of one of the sinners. It's sad. You know what I'm saying.
Oh, it serves me right. I'm not a very nice person.
It's sad, but funny. Oh, you know what I mean.
Grab me the wine from the fridge. It gets dry in here when you lecture.
It's not yet noon.
Oh, it's not yet. It's not yet. Don't give me that gadfly crap.
It's me. It's the money first now.
You, money. Everything is about you and money.
You're not getting a red fucking cent.
Red cents? It's air. All our money is air. I'm entitled to air.
I'm vibrating.
That must be fun.
Not a red cent. Hello, Bobby. No, I haven't. What? What? Why would... Who the hell is Bernie made of? Why would you? All of it? Yes. Yes. I see.
What? What just happened?
Well, that's that.
It didn't feel like burning or thrashing, sharp knife stabbing, poking, panic. It didn't feel like needles in my lungs, but it felt like blankets, warm woolen blankets, or soft arms, all gently pulling, moving downwards, holding, hugging on and on. It felt like, for a second, going home, for just a second. It felt like wishing I could see you, wishing I could say goodbye and feeling badly that I couldn't. It felt like feeling like I should. And so I thought about it, heart, And then I did. I said goodbye.
Good. Okay. Number one, the Jews. Okay. Punchline number two. The blacks. I kind of figured on that one. Here we go. Number three. The gays. Oh. Okay. I was kind of hoping... You're right. You're right. Last one. Punchline number four. The Catholics. Catholics are so easy.
I get a dozen eggs and eat them all.
Fried?
Nope. Strangled.
Scrambled?
Nope. Strangled.
With salt.
I like salt.
Didn't buy salt, just the eggs. Want some?
No, I better get back to work.
Oh, I see. You gotta be important now, goddamn assistant manager.
That's your job.
Dumbass, they fired me. Remember? What they give me?
$135.
Shit.
A week.
They're giving me $155.
That why they fired you?
I was cooking eggs, see, and some fella pulled up the pump set. I seen him. I can see the whole drive from a trailer. I can, right?
I gotta get back to work, Jerry. Car might pull in.
Have some eggs.
Sunny side up.
Strangle! Dumbass.
Hi, I'm Ben Traherne, and I'll be doing a monologue.
No!
Should I just start?
No.
No what? No, is that what you said? No. Am I at the right audition? Okay then, I'll just wait till you're ready.
No.
Is it my height, my hair, the way I look?
No.
You know, my manager told me the easiest thing in the world for you people to do is say no. He said I need to get you to say yes. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna stand here until you say yes. And you know what else? I'm not gonna say one more sentence that allows you to say no. You say yes, or I don't leave the stage. Simple as that, okay?
No.
Shit!
Catching the number 38, right?
Why?
Because I see you here every morning.
So you already know the answer. So what are you really asking me? I mean, is this about love or, I don't know, something concrete?
It's not possible to know which way the wind blows. You can lick your fingers, stick it in the air, but no one is that good.
That is not the way love works.
I knew what it was to be completely satisfied. I was like two or three. I don't remember now what it feels like, but it's in my DNA.
Right. Because if you touch me just right, I'll echo. And the emptiness will be a flagrant, not the other thing.
I've been thinking it's possible to leap over the inconsequential.
This early in the morning?
You are so damn beautiful. Like something purple and fluid.
It's momentary, like anything worth its
while. But I can kiss you. Really. Forever.
Only about 3 minutes of it would hold up in court. Here's the bus now.
Tomorrow?
Sure. Tomorrow.
She's done with you, Bob. She can't fucking stomach you, and neither can I.
She'll never be done with me. And you. You tell her that.
What are you saying, Bob?
It's not clear English, Russell.
No!
was really good for me. Good for you.
Good.
All right, we're ready. You can open up the house.
Thank you.